interesting thing with what they're doing with play calling. I see now that they were, you know, they pounded the ball the first half. They were trying to go over top and really, you know, take advantage of that play action. But I think after that first interception, you got to go away from that. You got to go back to what was really working with it. I mean, they were running the ball down Penn State's throat, inside, outside. Ezekiel Elliott, Jason Barrett. I mean, that's your bread and butter. Sometimes you just have to go back to it, and then they kind of seize up in the second half. Luckily, though, got into that overtime and really went back to the roots of running football and playing some good defense. I thought the defense played exceptionally well today, putting in a lot of bad positions with those turnovers in the second half, but still kind of held on.
And speaking of Penn State's defense, they coming into this game, number six in the country in scoring defense, giving up about 15 points a game. They were as good as ever.
They lived up to the billing, guys. They really did. We talked about the quality of Penn State defense. I mean, except, you know, coming into this game, Ohio State was fourth in the nation scoring offense, averaging about 46.5 points per game. 17 is on the board at the end of regulation. I have to think that felt pretty foreign to Urban Meyer and Tom Herman and those guys. But JT said it, just find a way, survive in advance, and the guys did that. I was excited to see how they were able to play a mature football game. I felt that this was a young team, but they played a mature game down the stretch. It was really exciting. All right, let's bring in Clay Hall. I hope he's still well, live from Beaver Stadium, guys.
Thanks very much. I think Ohio State fans saw the season kind of flat.